elevators. So you get really responsive. The rudders are, you have to tone down the rudders actually, because if you give too much, she falls out the sky, literally. Got a mongoose 2400 motor with 6.6 prop. 3S2250 Rhino. I really like the Rhino 2250. It's a little bit heavy, but it does. It's a good power pack. So yeah, the old MiG-29, mate. The rudders really make it good. Lighter than the Arctic pack, so the 6.6 is not too bad for it. The MiG can basically unload. You can give a full throttle and the 6.6 will unload. But the Arctic pack, being heavier, doesn't unload too much. So she's still, the old Arctic pack still carries a lot of load on the truck. So that's basically why I've gone back to the 6.5, because it's the 2200, 2826 in the Arctic pack as well, which is the, it might be an idea to change this mongoose motor actually, see whether, because this will work on 4S as well. I got a copy of this in 6mm Deftron that flies on 4S, but at the moment the Deftron is flexing too much with the stress. She's got carbon fibre in her and everything, but I need to find some way. It's the elevators. I think the elevators are too big, so maybe I've got to make them a little bit smaller. Because they really are huge, those elevators, because she was designed as purely elevon machine. She wasn't designed to have the ailerons on her at all, so I think they overscaled the elevators to compensate for the lack of ailerons. So maybe on my 4S version it's better to reduce the size of the elevons to stop inflecting so much. But it really is a fun machine. It's again another 30-35 euros of pure fun, really. So you don't need anything special. I got 9018 Metal Gear servos in her. The rudders are linked. You've got a single servo one side, and then a metal rod goes across the back on the trailing edge of the rudders to link them together. The ailerons and elevons are done by the single design servo in the side of the pod, or the side of the fuselage pod. I've got no extra weight in her for CFG. The 2250 is, as long as you set the engine around right, the 2250 pushes up against that main pillar in the front of the fuselage pod. And as long as it's pushed up against there, she's fine. And she does float. I've actually seen the water over there actually, she does float. bit small at distance, that's the only thing. Right, I was listening to the motor then more for orientation then. Because that prop in 12666 is really loud. So. Not so bad, is it, eh? Not so bad.